and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a makeup tutorial for you, and this time it's actually inspired by this old knitted sweater that I actually rediscovered at the bottom of my wardrobe. Because that's where I get my inspiration sometimes, apparently. The dark crevices in the back of my wardrobe. But yeah, it's blue and green, and so I ended up with blue and green on my eyes as well. I'm not going to claim this is easy, like I always have this tendency to say it's easy, but then again, anything is easy once you're done with it. Because, you know, then it's in the past. This isn't actually easy. Like, it's a cut crease with a line above the crease and a winged eyeliner. So, it's not easy, but it is a very fun challenge. And I do actually, to my own surprise, really, really love the color combination of the green and the blue. So, yeah, other than that, by the way, I thought I'd just put it up in the beginning of the video instead of the end from now on. Just to get it out of the way. If you want to follow me on Instagram and see more of my makeup tutorials and more of my makeup that I do on a daily basis, well, not really daily, but in the weekends, you can also follow me on Instagram, which I'll put somewhere down here below my username there. And yeah, without further ado now, let's get started on the tutorial. Just gonna start out with the primer just so that I can just sink into my skin while I apply the entire eye look. Just gonna leave my bangs hang loose for now because I just blow dried them and I don't want them to like cool down in a weird position and then have them suddenly be all crooked when I release them again. So I hope they're not gonna be in the way of the eye look. Then I'm just gonna quickly powder and prime my eyelids and then I'll get back to you for the actual eye look. I'm breaking all the rules here and applying a shimmer to the crease. I don't want to use a taupe shade, like I was gonna grab taupe first, but I really don't want to risk having the green be less green by having a sort of, you know, grayish brown underneath it. By the way, with priming, I always feel like it makes a huge difference, priming. But I always sort of feel at the same time that it's so boring, so I skip through it half the time in terms of what I show. But, you know, I do always prime, it's just the boring bits that I sometimes just leave out of the video because it's very repetitive. I'm just applying a deeper shade of green into the crease. By the way, you know, I do always recommend with looks like these to just apply your foundation and stuff last, because with green, well, it's just going to look very unhealthy if you have a faint green sheen on your foundation in the ends. And this way we can just, you know, remove it properly afterwards. And then skip on to foundation. But yeah, I'm just keeping the green really to this area, just really this outer corner of my eyeball. I've wiped off the brush and now I'm just blending out the edges of the green. It doesn't need to be absolutely perfect yet, but anything already blended is just, you know, a step forward. Now I'm just applying a blue shade. Actually, this isn't the shade that I necessarily have. Rather, it's a paler blue and a darker blue, which together create this shade of blue. That's really, I think, you know, just a great advice any time you do makeup. If you don't have the shade you want, just mix it until you do have what you want. Like, it's a lot cheaper than having like 5 million different shades and shimmer values and whatever of every single color in the world. So yeah, I do that all the time. Also, when I'm too lazy to grab another palette or something, just, you know, mix them until you're happy. But yeah, I'm just applying it in this area of the crease and I'm blending it together with the green. Then my, well, always present step in this entire thing, I'm applying my brow highlight very, very thickly. So we can just blend everything together later. Just doing that with the same blending brush as earlier, which has been wiped clean on a towel. Okay, I'm lying, I use my office chair as usual, but it's been wiped off is the point, so there's no product on it. Okay, I want to do something completely different today. I'm not yet sure which brush I want to use for it. I'm either with a concealer or I'm going to use an angled brush, I think. Okay, I just put some of my concealer on the tray just to make sure it doesn't dry out completely in the tube while I'm working with it, because this might take a while. But yeah, I'm going to use the angled brush to make sort of a gigantic wing shape. For the rest of the eye, I am using a concealer brush, because otherwise we'll still be at this 15 years from now. Okay, before I move on to filling this in, I'm actually going to use black and blue together to sort of darken the edge here. Just carefully move along the line and blend it out at the same time. Then I'm just gonna fill in the eyelid with a lime green shade. Also shimmery. The outer corner I'm switching to a darker green shade just to give it a little bit more depth. Now I'm just applying a mixture of blue and black again. And yes, the other eye also joined the game by now. But yeah, I'm just blending it upwards here a little bit to connect it to the top. Don't matter if you go too far there, because we're going to still, you know, do a winged eyeliner and concealer anyway. Then I'm blending it out with a mixture of pale nude and lime green. Now I'm just applying a highlight in my inner corner. This is a shade that's... It looks white, but it has a blue reflect to it. If you don't have a shade like this, then you can also just apply a little bit of shimmery white with the shimmery blue. Also a little bit at the highest point of the brow bone. Okay, first off, I'm going to just attack my pencil sharpener with a knife, apparently, because it refuses to sharpen correctly. But anyway, I'm going to have some fun with the pencil in a moment. You could also, for that part, use a white primer. But mine dried out, so I'm going to use the pencil instead. A creamy pencil will do, if you can get it sharpened. Okay, after all this trouble, this better work, I'm going to do a line in the crease. Like to the edge, the upper edge of the cut crease. I'm also applying the pencil in the inner corner to make it a little bit brighter, and then I'm going to go over all the pencil with the pale blue shade. We're not yet done with the challenges, now it's time for a regular liquid liner. Following the line of where the green ends, and just connecting it to the white. Then it's also doing a waterline in black, which is a lot less nerve-wracking than the top part. Also smushing it below the lashes, or between the lashes, as you say. So, just to prevent this video from being 5 hours long as usual, I'm just going to apply some mascara off camera. Then I'll just wash off the, well, clean off the powder here, like the eyeshadow. Then apply foundation, brow product, concealer, powder. And then I'll come back to you to do my false eyelashes and also the coloring of the face. Okay, face is on. Also, by the way, I finished up a foundation that barely ever happens. Like, I use my professional foundations, like the ones that I use in my makeup kit on other people. I do use up those. But I barely ever use one up on myself that I only use on me. But yeah, this is actually my favorite, the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage Foundation. Absolutely adore it. It's really, really beautiful. It's mattifying. It's gorgeous. It covered well. It looks natural. The only downside is, oh, and it's really cheap. That's a good thing too. The only downside is that the color range is quite dreadful. They only have 3 colors and they're all quite pale. So, yeah, it's good for me, but that's the reason I don't use it professionally on other people. But, yeah, I really hope they'll come out with more colors in the future. Anyhow, in terms of eyelashes, I'm going to use these. These are quite fluffy. And for who remembers, back in the olden days, they could be Eyelure, they could also be eBay, I'm not sure, because I stuffed them all in one tiny little box with tape. But yeah, I don't know, I rediscovered the box and I was like, let's just try if those eyelashes are still any good, we'll see. I gotta admit they're a bit stiffer than the XO Beauty lashes I'm used to now, but I gotta say they still look quite nice. Okay, time for contouring. This time I want to be a bit sharper, so I'm using this brush first just to put stripes down. Literally just put stripes down, really. And then I'm going to use a more fluffy brush to blend it all out. For blush, I'm using a peachy shade and just putting it on the apples of my cheeks. Quite densely, really. Also, this particular one smells like fruit for some reason, which is quite nice. Then for highlight, I'm using a gold shade to sort of counter the cool blue tones in the eyes a little bit. And I'm connecting it to the top here. Then some setting spray and then there's only the lips left. Okay, half of that setting spray is now hairspray, but we'll just ignore that. For my lips, I'm gonna keep it quite simple. I'm just gonna use a brown lip liner. Meanwhile, the setting spray can dry. And then I'm going to use a brownish nude lipstick. I'm just going over it with my finger. Also known as I'm also going over it with my finger a little bit just to make sure everything is nicely blended and there's no excess product on there, and then we're done. Now we're left with the final results. Yeah, I really hope this video was useful to you if you're starting out with makeup or if you just want to learn new tips and tricks for doing cut creases or whatever. At any rate, I really hope it was at least entertaining. If you want to see more of my makeup tutorials, chatty videos, sometimes piercing videos, sometimes baking tutorials, but which sometimes turn into fill videos, nail arts and whatever else I can think of, and requests are also always welcome. Point is, if you want to see more, you can always subscribe to my channel, I'd really appreciate it. And if you enjoyed this particular video, you can always click the like button, I would really appreciate it as well. Below this video, as always, you can find a full list of all the stuff I put on my face today. Obviously, you don't need to use the same stuff, it's just there in case you want to know specifics. But a green eyeshadow is a green eyeshadow. If you have one that looks similar to what I used, you can get the same results. And yeah, that brings us to the end of this video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!